this next bit's a really elaborate hole, right? But it's a fun one, right? And where this one comes from is, it's one of the masters he studied, Gojiru as well, but he's regarded as being kind of the last generation of pure Tamarite. He's a guy called Nakasone. And there's an old picture of him doing this technique, right? Which some of you may have seen. I threw it up on Facebook a few weeks ago, so let's do it. So we're using motor moves, back slap to start with, Funakoshi's arm bar, then we're spinning them down, and then we're going to go into this hold of Nakasone's to finish. Right? So again, we've got this arm from there, boom. Alright, we roll this in from here, we take it down there. And I'll just move you around so everyone can see. So far, perfect. So far, everyone okay with that, yeah? So that's that simple enough. What you're then going to do is you're going to put this leg across his back for the same idea of keeping weight on. As you do that, this foot goes to the other side of his head. I'm not finished yet. So the arm is trapped on him. It's a good idea here to grab the shoulder. Because one of the things that Nick might try and do is, if you turn to face me, Nick, so spin like yes, he rolls up with his daddy, he tries to do that. So if I haven't quite got it, he'll roll underneath and he's there, which is okay, but it just means I'm doing other things. Right? So once I've got from that position, if I get hold of this as I do it, that keeps him round. When I've got that, I then take the other arm. So I grab it and pull it back towards me, and this is the cushion. Right? So, here we go.
And he's got nothing to slap with.
That's the fun bit.
So
if I turn around this way, Nick, so I'll shove him to the side again. That's the technique as Nakasone does it. There's another little variation, which is sometimes tricky to get on. I'll show you that in a second. So then this is, again, you know, people would look at that and think it's just not karate, but it is. You know, there is this photographs of Nakasone, you know, regarded as the last master of Tamarite, you know, studied Goju again, picture him doing exactly this. So, you know, and again, I'd put it into the fun to do category, you know, but it's still nice to learn for historical purposes as well, you know, because one old master did it. So you put your thigh across the back from there, take hold of that back shoulder, put your foot in. Okay, so I'm pulling from there. You okay then, Nick?
Yep, I'm
allowed to do this. Pull that arm. It's easiest if you grab it from the elbow. Pull the arm, take hold of the wrist, pull it round the corner, pull it in. That's when I've got him. So that's like Nakasone's hold. If I want to be really nasty, I can put a tape on wrist on there as well. You've got more flexible than from when we did it this morning. Things are getting loose. Stretching the muscles off.
And then re-stomp the boy.
it's fun. Right, so you're there, knee on. Right? Reach and grab his back shoulder. So that way you can stop him from turning in towards you. Right? Put your foot on the other side. Allow your partner to shuffle and get comfortable. Once you've got that, grab the arm, pull it around. Then back up towards you. That's the classical hold. If you want to, you can bend the arm from there, throw through, entangle wrist lock as well. Okay? I mean, that's complexity for complexity's sake, but it's fun. Is everyone okay to give that another go?
Is it fun?
Well, it's fun for me, not much for Nick.
I'm only fascinated what he's doing.
Okay, go play.